So in this class we would be covering the basic steps of digital imaging stages. We would see the structure of a human eye, how we perceive the information or an image, and then we'll study the human visual system in detail. And of course, to visualize, what we require is light. So we'll see the effect of light, the electromagnetic spectrum, the adaptation of brightness and its discrimination in perceiving the scene. Now, the key stages in the digital image processing start with the problem identification, the acquiring of the image via a camera sensor or the human eye. And if it is by a camera, then what do we do is, or a sensor, then depending on the information that has been acquired, we might do suitable image enhancement techniques to extract or enhance the information contained in the image. We may restore the image for denoising or deblurring and removal of blur or degradations. Morphological image processing would be required to do extract the shape of image components, or usually for representation and description like boundaries, skeletons and edges. Segmentation is related to, you know, partitioning the image into smaller and meaningful parts or regions so that we can extract features or regions from that. Object recognition or recognition, basically a process where we assign labels to the object based on description. So how we select the features to, you know, make the recognition task easier. And representation is how effectively the feature descriptor covers significant regions. For image compression, we know that to reduce the requirement of large amount of memory that is would be required to store an image on a disk or a bandwidth to transmit it, what do is we try to compress the image such that my information is not lost, but I am able to communicate and access the data at a faster rate, store it as at a lower memory requirement. Color image processing would be transforming the image into different color models or doing pseudo color processing, you know, to extract or enhance a certain tones. Then we look at the electromagnetic spectrum and then focus more on the visible spectrum. The structure of the human eye and how the image is formed in the human eye. So how the object is actually placed in front of the eye is perceived and how the image is actually formed on the retina. Later we'll know that brightness or the way we perceive light is actually a function of intensity, and more specifically on what is there in the neighboring neighboring values or neighboring quantity of what object I am trying to perceive. And same way, we look at some optical illusions which actually challenge the human perception. Some more examples for color imaging optical illusions, like the reds are red, the greens are green, but why is my eye perceiving a different shade of red and a different shade of green? So this is all that we're going to study in detail in the class today. Hope to see you in the class. Thank you. References from where the course material and PPT content has been taken. See you in class then.